Hey everyone, up for review today we have Loam Leave by Yves Saint Laurent. This fragrance is versatile, this fragrance is sweet, this fragrance is fruity, this fragrance is spicy, this fragrance is fresh, it's fruity, it's spicy, it's woody, it's fresh, it's fruity, musky, woodsy. It's everything that I mentioned amped up to 11. The projection and longevity on this is amazing. For someone who your fragrance is eaten by your skin, this is going to be good for you. The months that this is going to do better in is going to be fall and spring. It's a little too heavy for summer and it's a little too fresh for the winter. The whole fragrance is sort of centered around this sweet accord that is it doesn't care that it's synthetic, and it's very, very sort of enthusiastic. Let's go ahead and spray it on paper and we'll get a more in-depth look into it. Now let's take a look at the bottle while that's marinating. I can tell you right off the top there's a very nice sort of like grapefruit pink pepper thing going on there. It's really nice. Alright, so the bottle here, this is the, I think the 1.3. No, this is the 2 ounce. So the 2 ounce bottle. It says Loam Libre there. Yves Saint Laurent has YSL on the top. This is plastic. Has been stated in previous reviews. Not a lot to go over with the bottle. I like the blue straw in the middle. Sticker on the bottom. That will be the bottle. The fragrance. Synthetic. There's also a very sort of synthetic clean accord in there as well. Now don't get me wrong, I'm going to be throwing out the word synthetic a lot during this review, but I like this fragrance a lot, and I normally do not like synthetic stuff, so keep in mind this is a very good example of using synthetics. The star anise adds a twist to the whole thing and sort of gives it not a bitterness, but it twists up that sweetness so it isn't just all in your nose like, ugh. The same way Loam does with the florals and the other light spices that go along with that. I'm sorry, people are moving around my apartment building. I don't know what's going on. Like I stated in the beginning, you do get sort of like a fresh grapefruit sort of opening with that pink pepper, and then it quickly dries into the violet leaf nutmeg sort of marriage there. You have the nutmeg, which is very dry, in with the violet leaves that are very Hi.
What up?
I'm doing a video right now.
Okay.
Yep, I'll call you back.
Okay.
And that was my friend, Lorik. What was I saying? Violet leaves are very sort of... Oh, I don't know how to describe them. They're very musty. They're very musk-like. Not so much green. They have a very floral tendency to them, and I get that in this fragrance. Now, in the base, and you do get a very synthetic vetiver, but the patchouli is... the variety that I feel is used in a lot of women's fragrances today, like Misty Olchetti and stuff like that. It's very cleaned up and it's very fruity. It's not dirty. This fragrance is really geared towards the younger guys. This one isn't so much for anyone over like 25, I would say. It's definitely worth a buy if you're younger. You're definitely going to enjoy it, and it might move you through the Loam line. I don't really appreciate any of the other Loams, except for the original. I find the original is a very nice sort of cardamom sweet floral thing. Kind of goes along with Tommy by Tommy Hilfiger and Hugo Boss number 6, along those lines. This is a giant synthetic mess, but it works, and it's a sweet, fresh, woody creation. If you want something casual for the fall and spring, go ahead and check this out. It's definitely going to be worth it.